Mixo is a powerful speaker, coach, and MC who empowers individuals and teams to achieve their full potential. Her practical yet thought-provoking approach and passion for making a positive impact make her a force for good in this world. Langudra, are you with me?
Yes.
Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Ah, come on.
I'm fast. Let's be settled. The movements are an extra tower. We are about to get thought-provoking material that will be
a force.
She is an author as well.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Mixo. Mixo. Your palm is at your camera. Iko pa shapele Mixo matsoho.
But I said, don't quit. Suffer now. And live the rest of your life as a champion. I hated every minute of training. I like the fact that he admits that he hates training. But the desire to be a champion was more than the hate that he had for training. So he is saying, there is potential on the inside of me of becoming something great. However, to become that great, there's a process called training that I need to go through. Most of us who have received prophecies, you are going to the nations. The nations will open for you. You are a voice to reckon with. But let me announce to you, the nations will not open until you go through training.
Come on.
I like what Aaron always says. He will say, if you don't conquer procrastination, forget about conquering nations. So today I want to speak about consistency. If you have asked yourself a question to say, what is the secret to success? The secret to success, that's what I have discovered, is consistency.
Yo.
The challenge is that we are consistent. We are consistent.
Yeah.
But the only difference is that, what are we consistent in?
Yo.
We are consistent in postponing. I will start tomorrow. I will start next year. We are consistent in making excuses. I don't have enough money. I don't have enough support. I don't have this. I don't have that. I don't have that. Let me announce to you, everyone who is great today had to start somewhere. And it does not mean that their circumstances were perfect for them to start. The problem is that you want to start fancy. You want to start with the big cameras, you want to start with the big microphones, and when you start fancy, you have I want to say, when you don't start, you delay the opportunity to build your content. So when you know about TD Jakes now, he did not start now. He started somewhere in a garage and he was perfecting his message. And when he stands and says, woman, thou art loose, it's not the first time he preaches that message. But he has preached that message to a 4 audience or 10 audience or 15 audience to perfect the craft through consistency. Oh, so your problem is, you want to see yourself in that newsroom, SABC, to say in a platform when you have not invested in building that culture? It's the same scenario with David. It is easy to say I can fight Goliath because there's a consistency I've built in the secret place where I was there. I've conquered a bear, I've conquered a lion. I believe with this strategy, consistency is the force that helps you take things by force. He is saying, I am not praying for war, I'm not a soldier. According to your checklist, I don't qualify to even fight Goliath. But I have been consistent in defending the sheep that I was taking care of. And he is saying, I was not a lion killer or a bear killer. What I do is that when the lion comes and grabs my sheep, I go and take back my sheep. But if the lion tries to fight back, that's when I will kill it. So in essence, this guy is provoking me because he is defying the armies of God. So consistency had to stand and defend David.
Result will expose you. You don't have to face Yes.
Come on.
When you are consistent, you build content. And the content that you build will attract continents.
Whoa!
Continents. You become a person of influence. So we want to be future influencers. You start by being consistent. That's the only secret. Now I'm gonna read you my consistent codes. Calm down.
I'm already crying.
Every person you can think of that is a success. They can be traced back to consistency. The fruit of consistency is not immediate. The fruit of consistency is not overnight.
Come on.
It is over time. If you have a river that is flowing and there's a very massive rock. Consistency can be as powerful as blasting.
Like
you want it blasting, then you just need the river to flow consistently. The rock is so strong, it will break. Because persistence will break any resistance. And you persist through consistency. People like consistency. Whether it is a seminar or it is a stop. They want to come in and see what you are famous for. So, as AMG Institute, if we are bringing the best, and now I go and invite people, and the following year we are inconsistent with what we were consistent with. Now you are turning away the potential of the people you were supposed to attract.
Come on.
So, consistency retains your people. Because they will come back and see what you are famous for.
Come on, Mishu.
Success favors the consistent.
Aye.
Success repels the inconsistent. So if you are not consistent, you are distancing your way from success.
Yes, sir.
So I'm here to say, do not do what you cannot continue to deliver. Once you have determined your path, stay there. Be consistent to an extent that even if we are not there, we know you will deliver as we know you as a deliverer. Be so consistent that you can't be inconsistent consistently. Being inconsistent is no longer in your system. Consistency is the belt that fastens excellency in position. If you don't do it repeatedly, you will never excel in it. So anyone who is excellent, they've done it repeatedly. There's this man, the one who created the light bulb.
Thomas.
He said, I did not fail.
Hey, man.
10,000 times. That will not work. How many times?
9,999.
On one thing. And then whether you fail once. The business, that works 6 months later. When you do Okay, failure, ne? It's feedback. Failure is feedback that you did not do something right. When you receive your test back to say you got 38, it means out of what was being tested, you understood 38% of that. But that says to you, you need to work harder in order to get 100%. So in essence, when you are being consistent, you are finding out what works, what does not work. By the time you get the platform, even if it's just for 3 minutes, you shift the world.
Yeah.
So if you don't want to be consistent, you are distancing yourself from success. Mm. Consistency is what transforms average into a master. Success does not come from what you do occasionally. It comes from what you do consistently.
Yeah.
A consistent man believes in destiny. An inconsistent man believes in chance.
In chance.
Paralyze resistance with persistence by being consistent.
Yes, man.
Are you still there?
Yes.
Or you're scattered?
I'm sure.
You cannot perform in a manner which is inconsistent with the way you see yourself.
Yes. Come on, sir.
If you see yourself as a great person, we expect you to see yourself in a manner that is consistent with how you see yourself. Long-term consistency will win over short-term intensity. Long-term consistency will triumph over short-term intensity. Consistency can beat talent.
Yes.
Consistency can beat luck.
Yes.
Consistency is the mother of all transformation.
It's the mother.
Yeah. This is the one I want you to take home. I've said it. Consistency is a force.
Yeah.
That takes success from force. You don't need connections, you need consistency. Consistency transforms ordinary
into
extraordinary.
Yes, man.
Success bows to those who master consistency. Consistency is the heartbeat of progress. Consistency is not a skill you are born with. It is the mindset you build through practice. And consistency will guard you against distractions. I have exhausted my time. Let me give you a practical example.
Sure.
We have this lady called Simone Biles. I hope I'm pronouncing her name right. Do you know her name? You don't know her name?
Simone Biles.
You know her. She's a black American.
Because she's consistent.
Leadership.
She
is 27 years old. She was born 14 March 1997.
Okay.
She is the most decorated gymnastics. Decorated in a sense of she has a lot of medals. And she has over 30 plus world championship medals. And 23 of those are gold medals. She's 27 years old.
27?
Who's 27 here?
Me.
She has performed in the world platform and has over 30 gold medals.
More than the age.
And then, number two, she started doing this gymnastics at the age of 6. And then she was late. Which was gymnastics, you have to start as soon as you can walk. Meaning you must start as late as 2 years. So it is said that their school, their preschool, was going on a trip, ne? So in this trip, they went into a gymnastics center. And at the age of 6, she saw those kids doing those things, jumping around. And inside of her, a desire to be a gymnastic was aired that day. And she told them at home to say, I want to do this thing. And they were, but you're late. And she said, no, I want to do this thing. And you know what is the secret? Training. She trains 7 hours every day. And she trains 6 days a week. She only rests on Sundays. So tell me, if you want to compete with her at a world scale platform, but your training does not match hers, you won't win. So basically, the day you perform, you are showcasing your training to the public.
Are you well trained?
Okay.
No. So, if you don't sweat during training, you will sweat in the platform of performance. So honestly, when I looked at 7 hours, I was like, but how much time do I spend on Facebook? How much time do I spend on TikTok? How much time do I spend on WhatsApp? And I calculated, if you spend 9 hours daily on anything,
okay,
in a week, that is 3 days.
Okay.
In a month, that is about 12 days. Okay. In a year, that is 5 months in a year.
In training.
In that particular, it could be social media. It could be sleeping. I don't know.
Netflix.
It depends what you are focusing on. But in essence, all I'm saying is, if you dedicate that 9 hours daily, 5 months when of the year, you are doing that particular thing. So with her, that's her daily routine. So she said something. I'm always stressed when I'm supposed to perform.
I don't.
Because I must beat my own record. Yeah. So now she's a champion back to back, man.
She's not competing.
She's competing with herself. She must do better than what she did the past season.
No, she's so the only one in the competition.
Born, others are there. But they're not there. Yeah. So here's the background. She was raised by a parent. Her mother was somehow struggling with alcohol and stuff.
Yeah.
So they had to take them and put them in a foster home. And then from there, the grandparents adopted them. So consistency can break through any background. It does not matter with your mother, with your father, but consistency can break protocol and create a platform for you. Yes, she is a model, a role model at 27, 1997. She's still alive. I'm not talking about someone. West part, she has trained so much that she created even innovative skills in that sport. They have named those skills after him. They call it the Biles floor, Biles vault, Biles to whom might not know this because it's not a sport that you are familiar with.
Yeah.
But all I'm trying to say is that consistency can break protocol and change the rules. She's coming with new styles because she has been consistent so much that what room they created, she is outside that room. Is the standard.
Come on now.
The standard. The benchline.
to you, you are too much.
I'm too much.
You are not dead.
Yeah.
I'm
too
much. Your voice carries power. But it is suppressed in your inconsistency. Hey! Greatness is locked up on the inside of you.
Yeah, oh, I believe.
Willing to go out. But you are consistently closing it in.
Yo.
So I'm saying, consistency is the force that will take success by force.
Yeah.
I'm not sure what area you want to excel in. Be consistent.
Yeah.
Going to the gym for 2 weeks might not yield the results. But going to the gym for a year, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years will show you results.
Yeah. Yeah.
I did say consistency does not have a fruit that is immediate. It's not overnight, over time.
No.
If you want to take a shortcut of consistency. And defend your championship. I'll still close with the same quote.
No.
Muhammad Ali said, listen to him.
No.
I hated every minute of training.
Okay.
It's not nice to start. It's not nice to train. But I said, don't quit. Suffer now and live the rest of your life as a champion.
No.
So there's a champion on the inside of you.
Yes, ma'am.
It's up to you to release it through consistency. Thank you.
My leader.
Go back to Chapel and Mixo Mulaudzi. I need your hands to be very consistent.
Yeah.
Consistency in clapping hands will convince.